Collinearity, Betweenness, and Assumptions, Level 2. In this video, we will go over 5 examples illustrating how to use the concepts of collinearity and betweenness of points. Let's jump straight into the first example. Draw a number line and shade all points that are at or between negative 5 and positive 2. Find the length of this shaded segment. In this problem, we are asked to draw a number line and shade the region between negative 5 and positive 2. Let's go ahead and draw this number line. The region between negative 5 and positive 2 would correspond to all the numbers that are greater than negative 5 but less than positive 2. So all of these numbers are between negative 5 and positive 2. We also need to find the length of this shaded segment. We can determine the length by taking the absolute value of the difference between the two endpoints. Doing that, we obtain 7 for the length of the shaded segment. And this is our final answer. Let's try the next problem. If the length of segment AC equals 24, the length of segment BC equals 8, and the length of segment AB equals 16, which point is between the other two? In this problem, we are provided with the length of 3 distinct line segments. We are asked to determine which point is between the other two points. We can start solving this problem by first figuring out the relative positions of all 3 points. We can determine this by comparing the relative lengths of each line segment. Notice that the shortest length is 8, which corresponds to segment BC. The medium length is 16, which corresponds to segment AB. And the longest length is 24, which corresponds to segment AC. If points A, B, and C are collinear, then the sum of the lengths of the smallest segment plus the length of the medium segment would add up to the length of the largest segment. In this case, the endpoints of the largest segment are formed by point A and point C. This means that point B is between these two points, and this is our final answer. Let's move along to the next example. Point Q is between point P and point R on a number line. The coordinate of point P is negative 8, and the coordinate of point R is positive 4. What are the possible coordinates of point Q? What do we know about the sum of the lengths of segment PQ and segment QR? In this problem, we are given the coordinates of 2 distinct points. We also know that point Q is between point P and point R. We are asked to determine the possible coordinates of point Q. We also need to determine the sum of the lengths of segment PQ and segment QR. Recall that if a point is between 2 other points, then all 3 points are collinear. We can represent all the possible coordinates of point Q by using inequalities. We know that point Q is between point P and point R. This means that the coordinate of point Q will be a number between the coordinates of point P, in this case, negative 8, and point R, in this case, positive 4. So the possible coordinates of point Q will be a number between negative 8 and positive 4. For the second question, we know that point Q will split line segment PR into 2 segments, in this case, line segment PQ and line segment QR, since Q is between point P and point R. We know that the sum of these 2 smaller segments should add up to the length of segment PR, which is equal to 12. And this is our final answer. Let's try the next example. Points A, D, N, and X are collinear. Point D is between point N and point A. The length of segment NA plus the length of segment AX is equal to the length of segment NX. Draw a diagram that represents this information. In this problem, we are asked to draw a diagram that is represented by the given geometric relations. The best way to approach this problem is by going through each statement and drawing the diagram along the way. From the first statement, we know that we have 4 points, A, D, N, and X. From the second statement, we know that point D is between point N and point A. So let's draw point D between point N and point A. From the third statement, we know that the length of segment NA plus the length of segment AX is equal to the length of segment NX. The only way that this geometric relation is true is if point A is between point N and point X. A possible drawing that satisfies all four conditions is represented by the following diagram. And this is our final answer. Let's end the video with the final example. Draw a diagram in which point F is between point A and point E. Point F is also between point R and point S, and points A, E, R, and S are non-collinear. In this problem, we are provided with a couple of descriptions of how a set of points are arranged relative to one another. We are asked to draw a diagram that matches these descriptions. Let's draw the diagram by going through each statement. The first statement says that point F is between point A and point E. So we draw a diagram illustrating this arrangement. The next statement says that point F is also between point R and point S. There are many ways in which we can draw this relation. For now, we will choose one possible arrangement and change it if we need to do some adjustments. The last statement says that point A, E, R, and S are non-collinear. This means that all four points do not lie in the same line. We know that points A, E, and F must be collinear. We also know that points R, F, and S are also collinear. Since points A, E, R, and S are non-collinear, we need to adjust either points A and E or points R and S to avoid having four collinear points. So one possible diagram would be two line segments intersecting at point F. And this is our final answer. All right, in our next video, we will go over more challenging examples.